color behind the lens. Be patient. You're all super creative. I mean, I've seen the presentation so far. I'm overwhelmed, and hopefully you will enjoy the ride with me. So I'm gonna start. Can we dim the lights before the لو سمحت ممكن نوت اوكي انوار قشطه. I'm gonna start with a short movie بما ان احنا هو في ساوند بس ما اعرفش ليه ما فيش ساوند دلوقتي انيمور.
ما فيش صوت يا هشام.
سوري
فريده تعرف تخلي فيه صوت
فيني واقفه. You do your magic. Can I? Are you so blissful? Okay. And I insist. Technicalities.
No problem. It's us.
No, no, no. It's the universe. Sorry, ممكن 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 yes, now it's working.
عمرك سألت نفسك هو ليه البيت المكان الوحيد اللي بتحس فيه بالراحة؟ عشان إحساس الحرية بيبقى جواك إنه شبهك أو بمعنى ده مرايتك بيقدمك للناس من غير ما تتكلم إحساسك في كل ركن فيه وحياتك في صور على الحيطان على طبيعتك تنام براحتك تاكل على مزاجك تضحك تزعق تشجع ما هو بيتك. واحنا بجي ال سي عارفين قد ايه البيت مهم ليك فعملنا لك اللي جدد لك احساسك بالبيت عشان بكل لحظه هتحب البيت تاني.
This was during the pandemic actually. We wanted to launch the new identity of GLC, so we went to Epic and then Runa Larian as a director, and we wanted to do it a bit emotional because we stayed so much at home, we hated home, so الفكره كانت كانت حتحب البيت تاني فحسيت انه بما انه we are in this environment super creative and ads and photography and social media and NFTs, we started that. This takes me to my second part, color, because color is an easy subject and at the same time color is an overwhelming subject. Color has a crucial importance in our day-to-day lives. If you see a brown glass of water, you will not drink it. If you see blue in your food, you will not eat it. If you see red on a traffic light, you will not cross. It's actually not you who made the decision, it's the reflection on seeing the light, on seeing the color. Color affects the decision you make, color affects how you are walking, color affects what you are buying, your choice of products, material. It's a very personal, it's a very intricate, and it's a very emotional decision. Colors, as Kandinsky would say, have lives of their own and minds of their own. Color is the first language a child learns. Lego is the most played or thought after toy, and they captured the mind of everyone because of these primary colors. علشان it's so omnipresent موجود في كل حتة sometimes we overlook it بس color not because we're a paint company بس color is super important فحسيت انه I'm gonna start a little bit with a bit of color psychology probably most of you know a lot about that بس blue I started with it because, first of all, it's my favorite color amongst 63% of the world population, because literally it's the most loved color. Blue is calming, blue is help you meditate more. If you put blue in a small gym, you can play, actually you can enhance your play, your performance. But Kamena blue is having the blues. Blue is sadness, and blue is introversion. Depending on how you use it, and depending on the tonality of what you, how you use it, blue can have various meanings. Red is passion. Red is jealousy. Red is love. اللون الأحمر بيخلي الهارت ريت يعلو. This is why we get excited when we see red. بس كمان red is alert and red is stop. Red is mostly linked to your emotions, as to our emotions as a human, and to your emotions as well. Red is sexy. يعني mainly in most cultures of the world, red is referred to as love. Every 4th of Feb, well, 14th of Feb, بنلاقي كل الدباديب في العالم كلها ماسكة قلوب حمراء. And it's a bit kitsch, yes. Red, pink is derivatives of red. كنت بقول لحد برا, because I want to stop at red a bit, because people think that pink is a male color, and actually pink started as a female color. Pink started as a male color, and pink was, because it's a derivative. It's one of the shades of red. Red used to be the officers, the army's official uniform. Pink was a lighter tone of it, so they used to dress rich kid aristocrats with pink. And then I think it was Madame de Pompadour, the concubine of Louis XV, who decided to have a beautiful pink dress and get out of it to تلبسو. This is why Louis XV style is called the style Madame Pompadour. So everything is pink. And then even Marie Antoinette fell in love with it. And then she made Sèvres, the famous manufacturers of porcelain in France, do a full set of her cutlery in pink. So pink is very, very much a male color, يا جماعة, as much as it is a female color. I will not talk about blue. Green is nature, green is calm. Green on a desk helps you focus more, helps you solve better. It enhances your mental abilities, because it's at the end of the day, it's nature. This is why it's one of the most used colors in children's classrooms. Yellow is jealousy. Yellow is one of the brightest, most engaging color. And yellow is one of the colors most used as well to highlight sales, to highlight products, to highlight whatever. But كمان yellow can be super irritating. Originally, in the history of color, بس شوي, they used to get yellow, they used to make yellow out of mango force-fed cow's urine. يعلفوا البقرة قد ما فيهم قشر المانجو, بعدين the cow used to have its urine, and then they used to use it, mix it with fats, oils and soil, and they used to make yellow. بس كمان yellow, انتوا بتقولوا سرايا الصفراء, بلبنان بنقول سرايا الصفراء, because it's linked with mental health. Yellow kamena is used in the Renaissance paintings on the Judas, as a Judas cape, علشان he's an outcast. Depending how you use it, depending on the era, yellow can have different connotations. Nonetheless, it's the color of the sun. White and black. White is the absence of color, or all the color. Black, I can say white and black the same thing. White is purity. its calmness as well. Nurses wear white robes, doctors wear white robes, because it conveys a feeling of trust. And despite what everyone might think, that black makes you look slimmer, white actually makes you look slimmer. Yes, because it reflects light.
You ask any girl who put on a pair of white trousers.
But I wonder why I'm wearing black, not white.
I'm wearing navy blue.
Yes,
حبيبتي. بس لأنه أنا نحيف مش شو سامباتي. مش معقول يعني بس إنه جربتي تلبسي فستان أبيض إيمي غير الويدنج دريس.
My wedding dress is white.
Black is king whenever they want to refer as the color that's dominating a new place. Green is the new black, orange is the new black, whatever is the new black. Black is the absence of all colors. It's the color that some people even say that it's not color as well. Black, depending on the culture, it's used in ممكن يكون لون الحزن بنفس الوقت in old Egyptian history or old Egyptian theories. Black is actually rebirth, regeneration, and new life. لأنه كانت المي تاع النيل لما تطوف الوحل الطمي المد اللي على الطرف كان كليته black. So the entire shores of the Nile used to be black, and it used to be a symbol of rebirth, regeneration. بس لحنا and it's a very old Jewish tradition is to wear black actually for funerals. But black is the absence of all color. Black is can be melancholy, but can be as well classiness at the same time. But this is a very, very brief part of color psychology. If I made you people lose interest, let me. color forecasting. Or color trends, or because people think that color forecasting is based on the whims and the taste or the preferences of a designer. Valentino اليوم نزل pink, فpink is the new color trend. Dior ما بعرف شو عمل. More for color to push this color because they wanted to advertise Coca-Cola. But this is the color trends. I'm gonna start with a small video and then I'll explain to you something. I'm sure you've all watched.
Yes!
And you're all familiar with this.
Yeah, and I've seen all this before.
Tessin is trying to reinvent the drapeway, so
actually. Where are all the other dresses?
We have some right here and then I have one. And I think it can be very interesting.
Yeah. No, it's just baffling to me. Why is it so impossible to put together a decent run-through? You people have had hours and hours to prepare. It's just so confusing to me. Where are the advertisers?
We have some pieces from Banana Republic.
Well, we need more, don't we? Oh, this might be. What are you thinking?
Yeah. Well, you know me. Give me a full ballerina skirt and a hint of saloon and I'm on board.
It's too much like...
I've got a croix from July. I thought that, but no, not with the right accessories. It should work.
Where are the belts for this strap? Why is no one ready?
It's a tough call.
It's a tough call.
They're so different.
Something funny?
No, nothing's, you know, it's just that both those belts look exactly the same to me. You know, I'm still learning about this stuff and,
This stuff? Oh, okay. I see. You think this has nothing to do with you. You go to your closet and you select, I don't know, that lumpy blue sweater, for instance, because you're trying to tell the world that you take yourself too seriously to care about what you put on your back, but what you don't know is that that sweater is not just blue, it's not turquoise, it's not lapis, it's actually cerulean. And you're also blithely unaware of the fact that In 2002, Oscar de la Renta did a collection of cerulean gowns, and then I think it was Yves Saint Laurent, wasn't it, who showed cerulean military jackets? I think we need a jacket there. Mm. And then cerulean quickly showed up in the collections of 8 different designers. And then it filtered down through the department stores and then trickled on down into some tragic casual corner where you no doubt fished it out of some clearance bin. However, that blue represents millions of dollars and countless jobs. And it's sort of comical how you think that you've made a choice that exempts you from the fashion industry when in fact you're wearing a sweater that was selected for you by the people in this room from a pile of stuff.
That's that summarizes I'm gonna have to do it now, I don't have food. That's a very tough thing to do, senor.
Yes.
Voila. It's extremely correct what she did. I mean, other than the magnificent acting of Meryl Streep, choosing color forecasting is about, it's not about the whims and the taste and the preferences of one person. Lots of factors, political, geographical, environmental, sociological, anthropological, facts and get together and they create color trends, or what we call color forecasting. The colors of 2022 have been chosen 2019, but then pandemic came in and then we had to change course. I'm part of something called Color Marketing Group. Color Marketing Group is the highest authority on color forecasting for the entire design industry, and not just architecture, fashion, everything. Car manufacturers are the people who invest the most in color trends, actually, because it takes 6 years from the moment you pick a color until it is on the car. This is how much knowledge should go into color forecasting. Lots of people meet from across the world. Each of them, designers, producers, manufacturers, paint people, fashion, psychiatrists, lots of people, they meet together and then they start putting together sort of a mood board of now 2022, I'm going in November to forecast 2025, actually. There's a summit that takes place in the US, but there's a whole year of preparation ahead of it. Each of us selects, we visit Guna Photo Week, we see colors, we see people, we hear things, we take notes. We start doing our old mood board, and then we assemble colors related to and images related to these those information that we've collected. Then we do small meetings called chromazones. These chromazones every month they take place somewhere in the world. We go and then lots of people talk about lots of things. We minimize them into around 100, 150 colors. Then we all go to the summit. Everyone sits in a very big room and we do a sort of a deliberation, which is it's sort of a deliberation of colors, talks, whatever is happening in the world. And then we bring everything down to 40 colors. And then we start creating themes. And then based on these themes, we start creating images. And then we give them out to the creatives, like you people. And then the creatives start putting in the story is the copywriting, etc., etc. And then it's a pool where car people, manufacturers come, plastic manufacturers come. Every single item you use, the bottle of shampoo in your bathroom was selected for you by the people sitting there a few years back. Because even if you don't see the difference between a nacré pink and the nacré beige, because they're very, very close, but it's a $1 million decision that took a lot of research. Whatever you're wearing, whatever lipstick, whatever earrings, everything has been not decided for you, but researched for you based on lots of economical, sociological, political factors. But this is how color forecasting is done, and not just come in. At the end of the day, it's theoretical. Sometimes people might say, "أنا ما بدي استخدم هيدا اللون، بدي أعمل لون تاني." I was doing a class with Dr. Ghalia, and then something triggered my mind because I realized that Bottega Veneta had changed their packaging. It was brown, and then suddenly it's emerald green, But the guy has been working, the designer has been working for 2 years, infiltrating the color slightly into his fashion shows, and then people started picking the color from different other industries, and then they changed the packaging, and then we accept it as if it was always their colors. They appropriate it, just like Hermes Orange, Tiffany and Blue Box. These are iconic. I'm going to go very quickly on the 2022 color trends. 2022 is about new beginnings. لأنه 2021 كان في الفاكسين. ما عرفش إذا بيشتغل ولا لا. I had Johnson, Pfizer, 2 shots, Moderna, 2 shots, and I think I'm still vulnerable for for Corona. I'm not sure if it's working ولا لا. But we had the vaccine, so it was the light at the beginning of the tunnel. So we had a very quick meeting in December when the vaccine was there, because actually we had to change the color trends, and then we had to see how the tones of these color trends. There are 4 themes, I'm gonna go very quickly on them. One of them is called Wasabi, which is based on Wabi Sabi, finding beauty in imperfection, because we stayed at home a lot, we meditated, we actually had the time, مش في مصر طبعا, احنا ولا يوم قعدت في البيت, انا كنت اليوم كل يوم بروح المكتب وبرجع. But we had the time to meditate, we had the time to actually discover our neighborhood, والخياط والمش عارف مين around us. ف Wabi Sabi, it's about rediscovering yourself, rediscovering you, what you want, and actually discovering your area. So the colors of this trend are very muted. Ah, انتم مش شايفين الوان خالص هنا.
Not the same colors.
The same colors. And actually one of the colors, اللي هو 4010 G10Y, is we renamed it a GLC FR green, which is based on Fayyad and Rashad, Malak Ahmed Fayyad and Malak Rashad, because actually they've used the color for one of our dear friends' seriality in TDS. The use of the color was so gorgeous because they used it as a color blocking. فنحن سمينا الكولر على اسمه. شيء كتير مهم كمان البالانس of the colors, how you people use the colors. مش يعني مش انه مثلا زي الكولر ترندز هيدي حناخدها ونستخدمها مثل ما هي. في بالانس للخبريات. لما انتم بتفوتوا actually a doctor wears scrubs are either blue either green for doctors, and it's because لما بيكون عم يعمل عملية وعم بيشوفوا كل الدم اللي قدامهم, العالم اللي قدامهم بيكون لابسين او ازرق او اخضر, so that they balance. مثل ما بتروحوا بتشتروا perfume, they give you coffee to smell different perfumes to neutralize it. Actually they look at a blue or a green color to neutralize the red, and then they can go back and work. And this is color balance. This is what happens every single second of our being, because في اوقات نفوت على محطه بدي خلي بيطلع من هون يطبقوا لي على قلبي. And then actually it's because الالوان بالغرفه مش ظابطه, so your brain made a decision. So there's a balance of how we use colors. Second one is symbiosis. Symbiosis, it's us rediscovering nature, it's us reloving nature, it's us re-enjoying nature, and it's us being super aware of our waste command. The colors are the colors of nature at sunrise, actually. It's, they are very muted hues of reflections in a water pot. كمان البالانس. اخر واحدة هي تالت واحدة سوري هي سبرينج. Spring is about us going out, partying, coming to Guna, getting together, falling in love again. It's mainly focused on Generation Z, and it's mainly focused on those people who couldn't attend class at school or at university. And they were constantly on their video gaming or on tablets or on Zoom all the time. The colors are super vivid, super bright. It's like a celebration of life. في إذا ملاحظين عم نشوف كثير أخضر صح؟
Yeah.
Yes. And then last color trends for 2022 is called restart, because actually everyone took a break, Earth took a break, and we restarted everything from scratch. And it's the first time since color forecasting started that we use black and white. Because actually, it's black and white are the absence of colors. So it's about restarting very clean. But Kamena, black and white, they need always something to put them in prominence. And this is where the blue comes in. And blue is going to continue next year. We're going to see reds, greens. But blue is going to dominate as well 2023 with us. So this is very, very briefly everything. All are good. ميرسي لو زهقتكم قولوا لي ميرسي ذا تايتل فور توداي كنا قاعدين مع مروه اجت صورتني بالمكتب كنا قاعدين عم نتحدث على على جونا فوتو ويك ف انا كمحمد بيتي في اشياء اثرت فيي كثير بحياتي كولرز اثروا فيي من لما كنت صغير ما بعرف كنت عم بحكي مع حدا سمارتيز أثروا فيي وسكيتلز شاين بحب سكيتلز أنا I adore سكيتلز فكمان ف and jelly beans and everything else بس in 2000 أنا حضرت I was doing an internship in Paris وحضرت in the mood for love you all know Wong Kar-wai you are all videographers cinematographers directors amazing people فأنا بتذكر أنا فت حضرت movie and I went out and then got a new ticket and went back in and then got out and then got in again because I, first of all I couldn't get enough of the music and I couldn't get enough of us what did I just see yani the guy took me somewhere completely different and I have the poster this is the first thing I see when I get into my house actually the poster of In the Mood for Love I were going to watch the trailer and then هلا بخبركم كيف In the Mood for Love عرفني على كريم الحيوان than me history of movies and everything else but Wong Kar-wai did not have a script zalame ma bi'amal mastil kareem el hayawan masak telefon w nazel yisawr ay shi bas without any script w fa yani Wong Kar-wai decided I mean he wanted to do this movie bas ma kanch fi script but then Wong Kar-wai is very very well known for his use of color he created probably his own style of smudging colors but In the Mood for Love is an absolute it's a very immersive experience لانه مش معقول انه someone uses primary colors in the way he uses them there's a lot of not red green blue and yellows and it's the story of the movie is very basic two neighbors they're who are two married couples two neighbors and the protagonists, the lead, they know that their partners are cheating on them, so they're sleeping with each other behind their back. So it's a story of deceit and deception. But some two neighbors that are being betrayed, they fall in love with each other. We never see their husbands. We never see the wife who is betraying. We never see the full picture behind the movie, as we see a lot of color. We see a lot of red for passion, for love. We see a lot of florals on the kippah of Su all the time, because يعني هو عم بيحاول يرجينا how soft, how sweet, how betrayed she is. The use of floral, the use of red, the use of green is strictly for the protagonists, for the heroes. And then there's a lot of black and a lot of blue for sorrow, for deception, to depict the other couple, the husband and the wife, that we never see. There are lots of, green, yellow, oranges, they are dominant. He never really tells us the story. There's a lot of sorrow and a lot of honesty in their faces. But again, you are constantly immersed. بطل اللون background. The color is actually part of the actors. The color is actually part of the story, and the color actually tells the story more or less in the movie. Of course, Wonker, why? سمعت كلمة هذيك المرات كنت بلبنان مأوسد. أنا كنت فاكر إنه أنتوا بس اللي بوظتوا لي الترمينولوجي عشان أول مرة سمعت كلمة حنمنطر حنكريت حن. And I was sitting with an agent like, sorry. فأنا اللي هو إنه عم تحكوا بالعربي وبعدين أنت حنكريت حنمنطر فاللي هو في يا جماعة طلعتوا كريت تو مونيتور بلبنان طلع عملوا أسوأ حنأوسد عنده أو سي دي مأوسد فهو he's just like each and every one of you. I've seen Ahmed Morsi's work and I was like, and then Ali, and then Shank yesterday, and then it's fascinating to put names to things I love. And they all have OCDs because they're super creative. I know that you're very, you don't have OCD, but you like to be in charge of giving the perfect image, which is rightly so. He gets into the super details of the makeup, of the color of the makeup, of the dresses, of the wallpaper, and everything in between. They never betray each other. They never betray their husbands, by the way, بالموفي. But again, color is no longer part of the movie. Color is for me the movie. It's a fantastic use of primary colors. That was the first movie. I'm sure most of you have seen it. If you haven't, please do. In the Mood for Love. And ما في script, ما في شيء بينحكى. The talking is so minimal. And the second and last step, the last part of my presentation, again talking about color, is the colors of Wes Anderson. We all know Wes Anderson, Great Budapest Hotel, the Tenenbaum family, I'm skipping my mind, but in Wes Anderson is a very big baby. And Wes Anderson is like, for me, like Tiffany or like Hermes. Color for him is a brand, because when you see the egg blue of Tiffany, you know immediately it's Tiffany. When you see the orange of a bag on the Hermes, although it was done by mistake, like only they used to have super dark brown bags, but then during World War they didn't have enough paper, so the only paper that was available for packaging was orange, and then they realized that it was a hit, and then it became the Hermes orange. Color is part of the identity of the brand that is Wes Anderson. So we're going to watch the trailer for the Grand Budapest Hotel, and then I'll end this.
The incidents that follow were described to me exactly as I present them here, and in a wholly unexpected way.
Who's this interesting old fellow? Don't you recognize him?
May I invite you to dine with me tonight? And it will be my pleasure to tell you my story.
Let's blow.
Something's missing. I don't know what it contains. I don't know what it represents. I don't know what it is. But there are traces and shadows of it everywhere.
Nobody's saying it's a stroll down the tree-lined promenade with the fire lady in the white poodle, but it's got what you'd call vulnerability.
I fear this may be the last time we have seen each other.
Why on earth would that be the case?
I can't put it into words, but I feel it.
They threatened my life, and now they murdered my only family.
No. Who'd they kill this time?
His body was found stuffed in a sarcophagus behind a storage room in the Kunstmuseum late last night. He was short four fingers.
Tell him Jopling says, come home.
Pretty picture.
Stop! I can't! I can barely steer! Look out the window!
Tell no one. He'll explain everything.
What happened?
What happened? My dear Zero is I beat the living shit out of a snivelly little runt called Pinky Banditsky. You should take a long look at his ugly mug this morning. He's actually become a dear friend.
I'm sure إنه كل الناس اللي هنا شافت شافت ال الموفي. And for me, this is cinematography that went beyond and above. Again, color is part of the identity. Wes Anderson went through lots of struggles with his families, with his family as a child, and it made him what it made him. His movies are an escape. They are a sort of a fantasy world, and he loves to create this fantastical world, but makes you believe that it is a fantastical world. Shank Berh كان عم بيقول بالpresentation تعولته إنه لما كان عم يعمل تكنو أول إعلان لإله كان بده الولد يجاوب بطريقة غلط بس يبين إنه كأنه حقيقة مش إنه there's a thin line. Grand Budapest Hotel is his fantastical world, or Wes Anderson uses colors to emphasize reality and to put you in a fantastical world that is very, very, very believable. His color palette is okay. في طبعا Tamer sent me lots of links. مشكورا عن Grand Budapest Hotel about the use of how the color scheme changes from one era to the other. But Anna, actually, what interests me as color in his movies is how he uses color as part of the personality. The good people are always wearing strong, saturated purple, pink, blue colors. The government bureaucrats are wearing always grays, and those people who just want to benefit from everything are wearing always brown. For his color use is not only aesthetically, his color uses actually to convey message, to talk about the personality of the people. They wanted to do everything in pink. I remember reading this, and then they said that, okay, if it's everything is in pink, people will not see anything else. But actually, what he succeeded in doing is that when you see this pink, you remember the hotel. When you see the blue, you remember Zero, the bellboy. I'm jumping through different periods. This is where he's using beige, because this is in a different period in the movie. But when you see purple, you would he stressed so much on it that when you see purple, you would remember the movie and you'd remember him. And this is how successful he is in creating his own signature using color. If a color stops being an accessory, just like with Wong Kar-wai. This is the brilliant Tilda Swinton, يعني بعدين حتى the juxtaposition of color, how everything fades, and he makes you believe that this actually is happening. Zubrowska is a true country. فالcolor scheming is unbelievable in what he does. And again, whenever we see such a palette, we remember that it links us back to him. This was it. I hope that I'm ending my presentation with a quote from the beautiful Wim Wenders, that there's always two sides of the photography. There's what you see as a photography, and actually as actors, and then what the director wants you to see. So it's part of him. He is part of this photo, just like into all of you. You have your personality in the work you do, and I think that the most successful works are those that reflect the personality of their creators. Picasso went through different stages, the blue period, and then he reached world fame with his cubism. Van Gogh, because of his mental disabilities, used extremely and excessively the yellow. The yellow color became his signature. There's always part of, when there's part of you, of your personality, of your views, of your struggles in your work, this is where it all succeeds. بتمنى اني ما كنت طولت عليكم وبتمنى انكم استفدتوا ولو نتفي مثل ما انتم فت كلكم فتوني. Thank you very, 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 very much. Love you. And thank you, Marwa. Really, it's such an honor and a pleasure to be here. يعني كنا فوتو ويك هيك. It's for me, it's an escape into fantasy, and it's an escape into a beautiful world that I hope it extends كل يوم. I've learned a lot, and I'm humbled to be here. يعني بشكرك for giving me the opportunity and the honor to be here.
Thank you. I want to thank you, Mohamed, for this is a very small gesture.
I want the Oscars to be.
GLC and what you have done to support this festival. ما ترددتوش تعملوا أي حاجة احتاجناها that affected our budget, and you were there behind our back. I will never forget this. بجد I totally appreciate it. فعلا. When I asked for one backdrop تبقى على البيتش, he made another one. كان عايز يعمل واحدة ثالثة كمان. He's just there for the photographers, مش بس لينا احنا كorganizers. He was there for the photographers, and I truly appreciate it.
And would I believe that the role of every manufacturer and every supplier is to support the community, and then the community of color is not only designers or architects or applicators, it's as well photographers, cinematographers, advertisers, everyone out there, because it's about giving back knowledge that we get. بس.
Absolutely, and I appreciate your blending inside the culture, inside the creative industry, the طريقة دي, and the GLC has positioned itself بجد in a different, and you're totally different from other paint companies, and
thank
I appreciate
you.
It بجد. Where we'll see more of you around, and
أنا بقي لغاية آخر الليل ما يعني هحضرهم كلهم.
Don't miss out on GLC backdrops everywhere. It's so cool. And كمان the big logo outside. It's also powered by GLC. So thank you.
Thank you, Liki. Thank you, Venus. كمان يعني أنا بس والله ما فيه لغة. Thank you.
كمان الحضور عندك يعني مهم جدا.
Ah, please. And you raised my curiosity. You said, I'm going to tell you how I got to know Karim Al-Hayawani.
Sorry.
I want to know the story.
لا, I've heard of Karim Al-Hayawani a lot. And I've seen his work, but I haven't met him. وكان في art exhibition في downtown Cairo. بعدين كنا بنمشي من مكان, كنت بمشي من مكان لمكان, ودخلت شقة كان فيها نيلي شرقاوي's work somewhere, and I fell in love with it. And then سمعت تن 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 تن. I was like, what? what is this? And I was drawn to the music, and I found the most beautiful, gorgeous installation with lots of TVs. I don't remember what's the installation name, I know, and I did the scene before the Zeka. So I remember I was mesmerized by this installation. So several TVs talking about, I think it's separation, longing, traveling. And then I was mesmerized because the music drew me, and then the picture perfect drew me. And I was like, this is so gorgeous. And I did not want to read. I just wanted to absorb it all in. And then I went and I saw the artwork and said, Karim Hans, okay. لازم تعرف على الراجل ده يا جماعه بس so this is how I got to meet every time he does something every time he displays something our life changes because we get to learn a lot from his extraordinary brain وانا بحبك قوي 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 anyone has any question for me قبل ما لو ما حدش عنده
أنا
إيه ده سوري سامية طويلة العمر
so I can see like endless choices of colors
yes
I just wanna understand one thing Gary I don't know how you guys control this but one year I am in for houses even
yes
and the mood like I see those white houses I'm like oh my god that looks amazing next year I see the other house that's like all colors and blue and champagne. How do you guys change our mind?
It's not us, you change your mind. Color is a very, very personal choice. Very personal choice.
Like everyone likes.
مظبوط because it might depend if you are so much احنا we are bombarded by pictures all the time all the time all the time all the time يعني طول الوقت ففي عالم بيجوا لعند كريم او نضال او ايهاب بدنا نعمل interior design بدنا نعمل مثل هيدا البيت بس نحط قلبه هيك ونحط قلبه هيك ونحط قلبه هيك ونحط قلبه هيك يعني they go to Pinterest they go to Instagram and they collect a lot of things اللي هو is an engineer and architect who has a known style why are you asking me Why are you getting me all this?
Okay, another question. I don't know if everyone remembers when the, and I'm sure everyone does because we never see any color in Cairo. When those houses were torn down, and then we saw all of the colors.
Venus. خدي حبيبتي لا لا بس حسيت انك عم تتعذبي كيف انا ما بحب تتعذبي
So I don't know if you all remember when we all were walking in Cairo and all of a sudden, even though it was a very sad thing, people houses were demolished and we were amazed with the colors of those houses and the green and blue and all of those stories. And definitely in our houses we don't use all of those colors.
Yes,
tell me what was, since you love Skittles and the stuff, tell me what was it like seeing all those colors, the fashion that it's like, because for me it was amazing.
Our dear friend Adham Nadim, who owns, is one of the owners of the Nadim Group, and they have something called Nadim Foundation that they document how the doors of Egypt are deteriorating. So Adham قعد على فترة ست شهور عم بيصور we have amazing pictures that he took with حدف بالطوب وركض وراه وهالخبرية. بس because for him he said sorry أنا حردع سؤال بس بدي أقول something super interesting. He said that Napoleon Bonaparte when he came to Egypt he got 120 scholars with him. To study Egypt and the Egyptian culture and the habits and the clothes and the food and the pyramids and all the Egyptians and he ended up with the humongous encyclopedia what was it yes I think AUC has one there and then there's a كلية الفنون في الزمالك عندهم حاجات حاطينها برضو في علب كده بس مش نفس ال condition بتاعت AUC هو قال إن when people are going to come now, if Napoleon came back now, what would he write about? What would he say about us? And then he showed us the pictures, and he was like, suddenly, لحنا العالم يعيشين ببابل بالتجمع أو بزايد أو whatever. في قطعة من مصر تعرض قدامنا. في قطعة من society اكتشفنا إنه it exists. بعدين كلهم ورا بعض. كلهم بكل الألوان بس it, and it showed you that there's a very big gap not only in and intellectually, socially, financially, there's a very big gap in the taste as well between these people and us. And I was fascinated by seeing this. I hope that one day Adham does something with this. But it tells you a lot about the society. It tells you a lot about their use of super saturated reds, purples, pinks. عشان دي كلها كانت غرفة النوم probably. It is shocking. But yes, color changes depending on lots of things, especially as ما بحب استخدم social class, but as يعني social background. As a feeling ولا بتريا. Yes, بس يعني اكتشفنا مقطع من society that was shocking. And I was shocked. And please, Mr. Ihab Mukhtar, باش مهندس. صوتك حلو علي.
طيب هنتكلم عن موضوع كريم بعدين. لا انا هسألك okay. سؤال هسألك سؤال شوية استراتيجيكلي
مش صعب
بس لا سهل شوية بس ممكن يساعد كتير اليونج فوتوغرافرز اند ديزاينرز. التشالنج اللي انت بتلاقيه كشركة اندستريال الكومبيتيتورز بتوعها بيروحوا ينفست ان هو يركب بانر على محل بويات ويساعد سبلاير في حته وعلى امشور ان انتوا بتعملوا حاجه زي كده بس انت بتلعب في اريا خاصه بيك انت قاعد بقالك فتره انجيج مع الكرييتيف كوميونتي وبتحاول تلاقي نفسك بوزيشن في حته الكومبيتيتورز بتوعك اي دونت نو بيتحركوا زيك بس اكيد انت عندك تشالنج انترنال جوه الشركه يا عم انت قاعد سايبنا وقاعد في الجونه مع الجماعه الديزاينرز ومش عارف ايه واحنا وي نيد تو باي ذا بيلز اند وي نيد تو فايند بلا 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 ديفينتلي يو ار دوينج ذا رايت ثينج ام شور بيكوز يو هاف ذا لونج تيرم استراتيجي بس ازاي بتحاول تحل المشكله دي لان اي ديزاينر صغير واحنا سوري فوتوغرافر او ديزاينر كنا بنتكلم امبارح على ياخد شغل كوميرشال اجينست هيز اسبيريشن ولا يشتغل فنان ويسيب يعني البالانس ده مهم ف having insights from a big company like yourself I think will help us all I think
هنخش في حته بوليتيكال we are a paint company and we are a company that needs to sell to continue for sustainability and to be able to do whatever we do. GLC as a paint company controls the Egyptian paint market more or less. We have one of the largest share, alhamdulillah, because we have good products, etc., etc. Definitely. لو أنا كنت بعمل talk مع Studio 34 وقلت لهم إنه definitely come the owners and they said okay لحنا اليوم بدنا نعمل we need to go. We have created a brand identity. We want to do a very big promotion. We have an ATL campaign. وخذ ال عشان ما يزعلش رامي الجندي ال 15 مليون جنيه دول عشان لما بقول مليون دولار اللي دولار طالع فانت ممكن تاخد الفلوس دي كلها وتعمل بيها وتروح عند شاين تقول له بونجور اعمل لي اعلان. تقول له اعمل لي اعلان. It's going to be a brilliant اعلان I'm sure. بس then Ali is going to do another اعلان for a different company and then someone is going to forget it because our attention span is extremely, extremely, extremely low. احنا our attention span is the moment of a scroll. But if you do something sustainable, strategic, you build up on it and definitely ما تنساش مقطع commercial. احنا بنعمل حاجات كتيرة قوي 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 بس ما بنتكلمش عليها بنتكلم عليها بالسيجمنت بتاعها مع the applicators who actually are the final decision makers the end users who don't يعني very very little لأنه في 5-10% they get interior designers and architects and the designers and architects they make the decision بس 90% of the market is the applicators we do work with them I invest a lot of time but none of this is seen because it's behind the scene it's B2B اكتر من هي B2C it's لازم نعمل حاجه that is relevant at the end of the day we have to sell whatever we're doing here is for a brand equity it's for brand positioning وانا I'm a very very big believer and thankfully the owners of the company they are with me on the same, they agree with me that we have to invest in the design community, we have to invest in the creative community, because this all comes back to us. We are partners with Photopia, and I'm sure that if designers بيروحوا بيشوفوا اللوجو هونيك بيعرفوا ان احنا ندعم فوتوبيا.
It's all, يعني it's all year round. يعني yeah. They support our studio because we need paint طول الوقت. So they provide us with paint طول الوقت.
حيفكروا المره الجايه لما هو يعمل اعلان يجي يعمل ابعت لنا الدهانات بتاعتنا. فديفنتلي يو نيد تو هاف ذا رايت بالانس بس ديفنتلي ذير از ا لوت اوف ستراجل بيكوز سام تايمز they don't understand the photography. ليش فوتوغرافي؟ شو عم نعمل بالفوتوغرافي؟ فيلم ماي ديزاين فعلا انت بدك ليه بدنا نكون بالفيلم؟ لا حبيبي بس لانه في كوميونتي that I want to reach that I can only reach on this level. يعني definitely محمد بيتي ما بيعملها with a commercial mind in hand بس at the same time if the company doesn't sell, محمد بيتي will not have the money to do whatever he wants to do. فإتس you have to have the balance. شكرا.